Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today's topic is introducing solids to your infant. Even though Nikash is now 16 months old, I feel like people are still asking me how I introduce solid food to him because he's a very good eater. I wouldn't say he's like the best. He gets picky every once in a while, but he's definitely a good eater. And so people ask all the time, how did I introduce solids to him? So I'm gonna tell you. First off, I like to say this in the beginning of videos like this. I'm not a doctor, I'm not an expert. I am just a mom and I'm just sharing my experience with you. So if you have any questions or anything, obviously you can ask them. I always recommend you reach out to like your pediatrician. In this case especially, it was my pediatrician who guided me a lot, along with like family members and friends who have had like prior experiences that I could take from. But remember, I'm not an expert in this. So if you have any real questions, make sure you speak to an expert about it. So let's start with like the basics of it. Most people will say that you can introduce solids to your baby around like 4 to 6 months. My pediatrician recommended 6 months. So I actually went to Nikash's 6 month checkup at the doctor, and she started asking me some questions, and then she said, have you introduced any solids to him? And at this point he was like six months and like a week. And I said, not really. The first thing that I had done right before he turned 6 months old, I noticed that he was teething. I got him this. It is like a little silicone teether. And what you can do is you can put fruit. I would get like frozen fruit, like frozen berries, and I would put it in there. And then he gets to just like chew on it. And he loved that. And that was like one of the first times that he really got to taste something outside of milk. So that was like the first thing that he tried. At that doctor's appointment when he was 6 months old, she basically said, just like introduce everything. Her advice was, when you sit down for dinner or for lunch with your husband, maybe make a little side something for him. Let him eat anything that you're eating, because the earlier you introduce a variety of foods, the less likely your child is to have an allergic reaction or to have allergies to food. And this is like what they're starting to find more and more with studies. She said, just go for it. Like, start really slowly at first. Maybe like the first couple of days, give like one food. And I started with like avocado, for instance, because it's like soft and mushy and I knew he could like gnaw on it. So I'd give him like avocado, wait a day or two, see if he'd have a reaction. If there was no reaction, I'd move on to like the next food. And then it was like banana. And so I gave him some banana and saw his reaction for the first couple of days. And really, she basically was like, this isn't to replace breast milk. Until he's a toddler, until he's like one, you're introducing solids more for fun and to like get him used to it and to like get him ready to be a big kid and to be able to eat solids, but don't stress out about it, because really at the end of the day, the breast milk is still his main source of food. So with that in mind, I made sure it was more like fun and not stressful. So I'd make sure he'd have a bottle. That was also her advice. Make sure he has a bottle. Wait an hour, then introduce some solid food, because you don't want him to not be hungry for his bottle. So I would always wait for that. Another piece of advice that I wish I would have followed but didn't is, a lot of people say to start with like pureed food that's like, you know, like veggies, like savory stuff, or like the stuff that's not so sweet. But I started with like avocado, and then I went with banana, which is super sweet. And then I went on to like berries, like raspberries and stuff. And he immediately like kicked into high gear with the sugar. He loves sweet stuff. He is hooked on the sugar. Like, he loves sweet stuff way more than he likes savory stuff. And I wonder if I kind of did that to him. So some people like to use purees. Some people like to go with what I ended up doing, and that was baby-led weaning. And what that means is I just let him kind of eat it. Like, if I was giving him avocado, I would cut it into small bite-sized pieces in the beginning, or I would like steam carrots, or, you know, sweet potatoes, anything that like just wasn't gonna be soft enough, I would steam it. But instead of pureeing it and spoon feeding it to him, I would just let him use his hands to eat everything. That way he can learn how to do it himself. And at first they don't have that, like, they call it like the pincher. They don't have the ability at first to like use their fingers to do this, their thumb and their pointer finger. But eventually you see them like kind of learning how to do that. In the beginning, they're like, you need to give them pieces that are like big enough for their hands to just kind of like paw and put into their mouth. And it's really cute to watch them do that. And they get really excited about the different types of food they're eating. I found that Nikash was much more excited about food when he was an infant than he is now as a toddler, and he's much more picky. But yeah, the pediatrician was kind of like, you know, if you're eating salmon, why not eat salmon? And one of her big points was, you know, just make sure that you're giving the baby food that you think tastes good. She's like, don't like over salt it or over spice it. But you know, she's like, we expect children to be good eaters when they become adults, but we give them this bland food that we would never even eat. So why would we expect the baby to eat that? Because they have taste buds too. So she was like, give it a little salt, drizzle a little olive oil on it, because as long as it's healthy and he's liking it, then he's more likely to eat it, instead of like giving him something that's bland and tasteless or just doesn't taste good. If I don't like it, she was basically like, if you don't like it, he's probably not gonna like it either. Another thing that she told us to do at this age was to introduce water, which was surprising to me because I wasn't sure when to do this, but she was kind of like, you know, give him a sippy cup of water and let him drink as much water as he wants, because it's not gonna like do anything bad to him. Like, he's not gonna get full off of it. And she was right. I would give him water after like every meal and stuff, in the middle of the day and everything. I'd give him a sippy cup. He really took to straw sippy cups instead of the ones where you like tilt them back. He really took to the straw, and he's still using a straw to this day, which is really, really awesome. He even drinks like milk out of a straw now. And there you go. He's been drinking water ever since. It's pretty good. I did not introduce juice right away just because I didn't want him to get used to like that overly sugary drink. I didn't want him to think like it's better than water, especially since I already know he's prone to like wanting sweet stuff because he just loves it. But one thing that the doctor did tell me that he absolutely cannot have until he's a year old, and I didn't realize this, is honey. Apparently there's something like botulism in honey. It's very rare. She even said to me, it's like, it's really rare that something actually happens to your infant, but they have found studies that show that it can happen, that your baby can get sick if they have honey as an infant. So honey is the one food that she was like, nope, do not give it to him until he's a year. So I cleared away from the honey. Another tip she gave me was to keep children's Benadryl in my home the minute I introduced solid. So that day I went to CVS, picked up some Benadryl. I have not had to use it yet, but she said have it in your house in case he does start having an allergic reaction to some kind of food. At least I can give that to him and then call the doctor ASAP, right away. That way we know. Or if it's like an emergency, obviously call 911. I guess that like helped ease my mind was knowing that I had some Benadryl in case something happened. And I'll tell you guys, when you're introducing solids, you get nervous. There was a time when he just like made like a coughing sound one day, and I freaked out. I like immediately took him out of his high chair and I like flipped him around and I like start hitting his back and stuff to make sure he wasn't choking. And he wasn't choking. I was just panicking. And I feel like that's the stuff that just happens. You're just like so nervous when you're a first time mom and you're trying to like introduce solids to your child. I think it's just normal. So just be aware of that. Take a CPR class. I think that's really helpful. It makes you feel more at ease that you'll know what to do in case something happens. Make sure you're not, you know, giving stuff that your child won't be able to chew or to, you know, that they could choke on easily, like whole grapes, for instance. I actually just don't really give him grapes at all to this day, just because I feel like there's still such a choking hazard. Up until like they're three, a lot of stuff is a choking hazard, like popcorn or chewing gum or hard candies, anything like that that you're gonna worry about. I just don't even bother with it. And some other things to have with you, you know, Nikash didn't really start using plates until he became a toddler. But one plate that I love, this is by Avanchi. This plate has a suction cup on it. You can find lots of different brands that have this, and it sticks onto his high chair. Before he started using plates, I would actually just place the food, and sometimes I still do, just place the food right in front of him on the high chair, and that acts as the plate. I do that even at restaurants. I put out like a placemat and put food on top of it, and that's how he eats. But as he's getting older, he's starting to like realize we use plates, for instance. So I separate his food out. I put like some fruit here, and I put some veggies here, and I put like the entree there. I suction cup it onto his high chair because he will definitely toss it. So this is really good to have a suction cup when you do start to introduce a plate. And you can do that as soon as you get into introducing solids, or you can wait until later, which is what I did. Same goes with silverware. I just let Nikash use his hands up until he actually still uses his hands a lot to eat because it just comes very naturally to him. But I've noticed recently he's very interested in us using silverware, like our forks and stuff. So he's been using these. They're by Cheeky Kids. And what I do is I let him use them to stab because, you know, if I give him a spoon, what happens is he just flips the food He understands the concept of a spoon, but he doesn't have the coordination yet to like spoon it and then put it in his mouth. So he spoons and then he flips it. But he does understand stabbing it. So if it's soft food, he can stab it. And if he's having a hard time, I'll just help him and I'll hand it to him. And sometimes I give him two forks, like one that he can chew on and play with and one that he uses. And we kind of like go back and forth. Like I hand him this one with some food on it, he puts it in his mouth and then he like holds onto it and plays with it. And with this one, I'll stab another piece of food, give it to him, and then we like trade. So it's like this kind of like a game while he's eating. It's like switch of the forks until he's done eating his food. And he understands the concept, he really does. It's really cute to watch. But I waited until he was interested in using these. Obviously, you're gonna use bibs. These are actually like his little burpee ones. And then they eventually have now turned into, because they have a clip, they've turned into his bib. And what I like about these is they cover large surface areas of his shirt because he gets messy. I mean, he gets messier now, I'd say, actually, than he did when he was younger, because he doesn't give a whatever, because he doesn't care. He doesn't at all. He does not care if he gets dirty. So if you care, this is nice to have. And also it's nice to just like wipe up his mouth with it afterwards. Another thing, you guys, I gave into the super puffs. I did not want to. I feel like there's no like real nutritional benefit to these, but every kid is obsessed with these. These are like crack. And I find that sometimes when Nikash is being really fussy, when I put him in his high chair, if I give him some of these, he loves them and he'll chill out and he gets really excited. If I take these on airplanes, whatever, they disintegrate in the mouth and they teach them how to chew and how to eat and stuff. So, and they have fun flavors. So I gave into these because they just work. There's something about them. They're like crack for babies and actually for even big kids, because when I pull these out in front of other kids, they just like remember these from their like babyhood. So they like all eat them. But one thing to know about these is once you open them, they only stay fresh for about a week, so you have to toss them after that. So I try to get these done with in a week because they'll get a little harder and more stale after you open them. So something to know, because they could become not a choking hazard, but maybe, you know, you just want to make sure that they're fresh. That way they disintegrate in the mouth. So those are my tips and my experience with introducing solids to my now toddler, but when he was an infant. I hope that it's helpful. Obviously, you can ask me any questions that you want. There's things that, you know, you start to forget after time passes. It's amazing how much you can forget from being a mom. You know, you like get so stuck in the moment of what you're doing right then. But that is my experience. I hope it's helpful for you. I hope it gives you some basic information and answers some questions. If not, again, find me on Instagram. You can ask me questions there by DMing me or just ask in the comments below. Thanks for watching.